After witnessing the beautiful beaches of Chennai and also watching the hustle between the fishermen and the customers, we decided to go to the San Thom Basilica Chapel in Chennai. For all those who do not know, San Thom is basically Saint Thomas, and he is one of the 12 disciples of Jesus. This Gothic style cathedral was built in the 16th century by Portuguese explorers over the tomb of Saint Thomas. This is one of the three churches in the world where an apostle of Jesus is entombed. Now let me tell you about the sacred tomb. As I said, the church was built by the Portuguese explorer in the 16th century, became a cathedral in 1606. And was later rebuilt by the British in the 19th century. Pope Pius XII honored this cathedral church, elevating it to the dignity and rank of minor basilica in March 1956. The exact place where Saint Thomas was buried is marked by the second small tower in the center of the cathedral. Thank you guys for still watching this video, and because you are watching, I will speak about the architecture as well. And if you are still liking my video, do care to subscribe and hit the notification bell for all my upcoming videos. Now let's continue with the architecture. San Thom Basilica has all white facade and is built in neo-Gothic style with big windows and naturally lit interiors. The windows have colored panes and the rows of wooden pews add to the church's beauty. The calm and comforting interior has an aura of peace to it. Inviting all those who seek peace and tranquility. The place was renovated and restored in December 2004. Now that we know that Saint Thomas was one of the 12 disciples of Jesus, this church near the shore is dedicated to him. He is often called the patron saint of India for spreading Christianity in the country. Saint Thomas landed in 52 CE and baptized several Indians. He spent a few years in what is now called as Saint Thomas Mount in Chennai, performing miracles for believers. After his death in Chennai, he was laid to rest at the cathedral's present site. The presence of his tomb makes this church a holy shrine. Last but not the least, this church also has a museum attached to it. The museum has the great apostle's fingerprint, and there are wall paintings depicting the saint's life and death. It also holds the lance head that killed him, an episcopal chair, a rare piece of his precious bone, and a stone receptacle. A sundial from the old site is placed in the rear of the basilica. It is very close to the shore, and sometimes when the city quiets down, one can hear the waves of the ocean while sitting inside the basilica. Its close proximity to the ocean makes it one of the most beautiful churches in the world. I hope this video encourages you to visit this basilica soon. Do share your views in the comment section below.